So
Sure,
you
definitely.
can ask the questions for all sessions since morning, whatever we have conducted. So all questions can be answered for all sessions. So we expect your feedback, your questions. Yeah, Remote Center 1205, Mahatma Gandhi Mission College of Engineering and Technology, Noida, UP. Yes, sir.
How can we decompile?
How to
.apk file to reach its source code?
Reverse engineering, something like that.
Okay, first, I mean, this is a something reverse engineering you are talking about. First, try to learn how to create an APK file from Java code. I mean, that is something most important right now. To decompile the .apk and all, there are some tools available. It's pretty difficult. But first, emphasis is on from Java bytecode, please try to create an APK, try to install on Akash tablet. Please follow the straightforward procedure rather than the reverse engineering. Remote Center 1207, Jawaharlal Institute of Technology, Borwan, MP, Madhya Pradesh. Yes, please go ahead.
We are Windows users, so the process of installation in Windows, Microsoft Windows, XP, and
okay.
What is the? I want to know the process of installation in that case.
You can just download from the Android developer site that ADT bundle, that is 32-bit or 64-bit, whatever your system. Okay, just download that ADT bundle and extract that folder into anywhere into your drive. After that, you will get two Eclipse, sorry, two folders inside that folder. So first is Eclipse, another is SDK, and third file you will get, that is SDK manager.exe. Just run that SDK manager, it will start automatically installing the all versions of your SDK. Mm. And after the same, you can create AVD and run create new application. Same way you can do that. Inside the window, inside the Windows ADT bundle, you will get one more file, that is sdkmanager.exe.
Hello, yes. Sir, if I have a 2.3.6 gingerbread version, then can I expand it to 4.0 version for my mobile?
Upgradation on mobile. Sir, that depends, that is, you are talking about the upgradation of OS on your mobile, right? If I am not wrong. You want to go from gingerbread to some updated version. So, I mean, that is something depends on your device. I mean, it is possible, definitely upgradation of any OS is possible. I mean, from Windows XP, you go to Windows 7. So, similarly, similar concept, it is possible.
Ma'am, great pleasure to talk with you. This is Ritesh.
Same
my
here.
Question is, why other other apps are not compatible with the Android?
What do you mean by other apps? Can you define it? It's a very generic term.
Means Apple apps and Nokia apps are not compatible with the Android. What is the reason behind it?
Sir, Nokia apps are not developed on Android. You have special answer now.
Good afternoon, I am Professor Phatak here. I actually came for a short while to introduce a great friend of ours and a top IT expert. But I was very curious to listen to your questions. So let me give you an answer. There is nothing like an application is not compatible with this operating system or that operating system. Any application is primarily written in some programming language. It could be in Java, it could be in C, it could be in C++, it could even be an assembly program. Typically, when you develop an application, you port it on a particular operating system, and from that point, the application works on that operating system. Now, if the developer of that application has written it and ported it on one operating system and only released the binary version of that application, obviously that application cannot run on any other operating system. But if the developer has released the entire source code of that application, then there are multiple ways of porting that application elsewhere. For example, you can simply compile it and combine it with the libraries for the new operating system and release it. In the worst case, an application in C can be rewritten in Java and can be made available on Akash. So the question is not very correct. You cannot say whether this application is compatible or not. Application is an independent thing. It has been released on a particular operating system. For example, if you take the Apple computer, Apple runs a different operating system. It is not the same as Android. It is not the same as Linux. It is not the same as Microsoft Windows. It's a different operating system. And when you have an application whose only version available is a binary executable, then obviously it will work only on the specified operating system. It will never, as it is, it will never work automatically elsewhere. So what we should be really talking about is whether we can port one application or whether we can install an application in a different operating system. As I said, the answer is generally not. You will have to at least recompile, reconfigure, and in the worst case, you will have to rewrite. I hope this answer is adequate.
Yes, sir.
Before going to any new remote center, you can just go to, we are going over to Mandidi, Bhopal. But before you ask the question, I can see this young lady very enthusiastic. But can you just hold on for a minute, if you don't mind?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. I am indeed very privileged and happy to introduce our friend Ashank Desai. Ashank, can you please come over here? So, Ashank Desai is a distinguished alumnus of IIT Bombay. He is my contemporary from the institute, just few years difference, I think. He founded Mastek. Some of you might have heard of Mastek as an IT company. He and Mr. Sudhakar Ram actually initiated that many years ago. It's an extremely successful IT company. More important than that, he has been working in the leadership position in the IIT Alumni Association and in the Pan IIT Alumni Association. Still more important than that, his heart is completely devoted to education. And today he had come to discuss with me the possibility of training teachers and students in primary schools and high schools in Indian languages so that the students from smaller places, rural places can benefit from the computer education. We have almost finalized a plan. In fact, just before we went over to Bhopal, I think we were interacting with the remote center in Borma, right? Borma, as you would know, is a relatively smaller town in Madhya Pradesh. And one of the high schools which we have already selected for a pilot experiment with the high school students, 9th standard students, is in Khargon district, Bhikangaon. I think the Akash Project Center at Borma is going to look after that school. Why I mention all of this is that all of you students, when you participate in the application building contest, which I announced in the morning, please ensure that not all of you work only on engineering educational applications and engineering educational contents, but some of you at least should be fired to develop useful applications in Indian languages for use in our schools. Ashank, would you like to mention something to them?
Thanks, Professor Phatak. He has been a great friend and I almost missed being his student, looks like. He was 3-4 years ahead of me. But he has always been a great supporter and kind of work that he is doing is phenomenal. As you know, he has got Padma Shri, which was late, I think, given the work that he is doing. So whenever something has to be done for large masses, I always come and trouble him. So today I was talking to him about the primary student teachers. But coming to you, wearing my hat of Mastek and NASCOM, which is an association, we need large number of IT graduates from all over the country. And our issue today is we are not finding as many as we want in terms of the kind of quality that we need. So really, Professor Phatak and all of you, whatever you are doing is really great job. Because today, only people in Mumbai and Bangalore and Delhi and, you know, and IITs and so on are not enough. We need large number of students. So what is the best way you can do is what you are doing. So I must thank you wearing my IT industry hat. So that's one. Second is, see, today we are having IT industry in 5 cities, you know, Hyderabad, Bangalore, NCR in Delhi, Mumbai and Bangalore and Pune. That is 90% of industry. We cannot grow 5 times, which is what we want to do over next 15 years, by on these 5 centers. We have to go to all the smaller towns in the country, but we can't go unless we have talent all over. So I'm really happy that you are training people at remote places, Professor Pathak and all of you.
So
that, you know, you are doing a great job for IT industry, and I must talk more about it.
Yes.
It's good that I came today.
Thank you, Ashank. So since we are talking to an institute in Bhopal, may I take it that MassTech would soon be starting a branch in Bhopal so that a large number of Bhopal students can actually join you as good programmers?
We'll look at that.
And what we need to ensure is that our students who pass out become first-rate programmers, first-rate problem solvers, and that is what you have to imbibe. Not just understanding how to develop applications, but write very good code, write very good documentation, have a great clarity on what you are doing, and that is what we are trying to attempt to get this. I am sorry for intervening between the important interaction. This young lady has been desperate to ask her question, so I would suggest please go ahead and do that.
Sir, when we create an Android application project and then we run it successfully, then where we could find the APK files in our Package Explorer project folder?
So in your Android project structure, basically inside your workspace, you will, whenever you will create a new application project, one new folder will get created. Okay, workspace is nothing like a working directory for you. If you have, you know, seen the, if you have done any time C programming, what do? You keep all your programs in one directory. That's what workspace does it for you. It is just that along with your code, there are lots of other things around the Android which get saved in your working directory, that is in workspace. So inside your workspace, you will have your application project. Inside that, you will have bin folder, and inside bin folder, you will get that .apk once you compile your application and run it on an emulator. After that only you will see .apk file inside your bin folder of your application project under your workspace. I hope that answers your question. Any more questions, please?
May I ask one more
question? Yes, definitely. Go ahead.
Ma'am, you said that SQLite database is used in Android for structured database. Then for unstructured database, which one is used? In the session 1, unstructured database such as doc files and PDF files, which type of database is used instead of SQLite?
See, basically, I mean, unstructured database, that's what. So if I get your point, you want to read out a doc or .pdf file, so that you can directly store. Yeah, tomorrow anyway we have a dedicated session on SQLite, so there you will come to understand this point.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
My question is that why is Google change in Android?
Why Google changed to Android? I mean, they came up with Android for basically touchscreen devices. I mean, this is a need for an hour. I mean, if anywhere you go, you always see a touchscreen device. That's why they had to come up with Android. I mean, I don't find any other reason why Google came with Android.
Okay, ma'am. And my next question is that what is involved in releasing the source code for a new Android version?
Can you please come again? I could.
What is involved in releasing the source code for a new Android version?
Ma'am, I think he is asking that what is the change in the enhanced version of Android in the point of from seeing the previous version. What is the difference in previous and enhanced version of the Android?
So, see, I mean, what do you understand? For example, if you develop one software, there will be always revisions of it. There will be always some, you know, loopholes in your software which you will try to overcome in your next version. Same concept. Android has came first in market. There were lots of loopholes. It was slow. UI was not that good. So they started coming up with a newer and newer versions. I mean, that's the logic. Thank you. Center 1107, Purnima Group of Institution, Jaipur.
First of all, thanks for conducting this workshop, ma'am. I am Deepak from Purnima College of Engineering, final year student. मैम मेरा क्वेश्चन ये था कि आपका जो ये एंड्रॉयड आईडी है मैम वो जावा के अलावा किसी और लैंग्वेज के साथ भी कंपेटेबल है क्या?
यस, एक्लिप्स आईडी कैन बी यूज फॉर मल्टीपल लैंग्वेजेस. इवन यू कैन कोड इन सी, सी प्लस प्लस, इवन जावा, ऑब्वियसली एंड्रॉयड तो है ही, इवन पाइथन. देर आर लॉट्स ऑफ प्लगइन्स अवेलेबल यूजिंग विच यू कैन डू इट. आई मीन दिस आईडी इज कंपेटेबल फॉर लॉट्स ऑफ लैंग्वेजेस. यस,
ओके. वन मोर क्वेश्चन मैम. मैम ये जो Eclipse IDE का इंस्टॉलेशन है उस पर JDK के वर्जन का कोई फर्क पड़ता है क्या?
1.5
मतलब JDK का वर्जन कोई 1.5 हो, 6 हो, 7 हो, उससे फर्क पड़ेगा क्या?
वी नीड JDK 1.6 एंड अबव और अबव, या 1.6 प्लस बेसिकली.
अगर और कोई होगा 1.57 तो
इट वोंट बी सपोर्टेड. यस, यू नीड 1.6. Remote Center 1010, SVNIT, Surat.
I want to do the rotate operation on an image. So I am picking it up from the gallery and using an intent to store it in the image view. And in the, I am using the next activity to do take the input from the user by how much degrees I want to rotate it. But ultimately, when I am going back to the previous intent, in the previous activity, I am losing the image. Which was, means I was fetching from the gallery. So do in that case, means how can I retain it?
Basically, are you, if I'm not mistaken, you are trying about, trying to do achieve an animation. I mean the image rotation can be done by using view animation, and there are a lot of animation attributes which can be used. I didn't get your problem exactly. You said that from first activity you are going to next. There you are asking user to choose a file and then something coming back and something is happening. Can you just reframe or just come again?
Just want to ask ki, in one activity I am taking the intent in which I have stored the image, and in the next activity I am taking user input like 20 degrees or 30 degrees. When I am returning back to the original activity, I am losing the intent image. So how to retain that image?
Yeah, definitely. If image is not getting stored, then there is some issue with your coding. I mean, you are not retaining it.
If you are coming back, then
yeah. And if there is issue with the rotation, then that comes in the animation segment, which we will have it on a third day afternoon session. If you are not able to rotate it, if you want to know about the animation, so please attend the third day afternoon session for it.
Yes, ma'am. There was an example which was shown by you regarding the activities.
Okay.
There were two activities. First, we entered certain thing like some name in the first activity. We moved to the second activity. Okay. In the second activity, we again had a back button by which we were moving to previous intent again.
Okay.
Right now, when we are moving to the previous intent, the data which was actually entered is lost. So our question is, how can we retain the data which is there in the first intent or first activity, move to another activity and come back to the same activity with the same data?
So see, basically if you have understood, activity is a class. Activity has lots of method, lots of attributes to do things which you are talking about. For example, if I am in a current activity, I want to go to next and I want to pass some parameters. There are methods available to do that. If you are coming back and if you expect another activity to give you back the result, there is a method called as start activity for result. So what it does is, it gives you the result back. So for example, suppose it's a camera application. I am opening a camera, it's giving me an image back. So it gives a raw data which you can typecast to the corresponding data you expect from the activity. So there is a method called as start activity for result. So instead of just start activity, you can use start activity for result if you expect some result to be back from the other activity. I hope that answers your question.
No, ma'am, I'm sorry. Just one last time. Yeah, what I mean sure. to say is there is some image as the, yeah, there is some image which was shown on the screen, on that activity screen. Okay, I move to another screen, I come back to the same screen, the image is gone. So that is my question. Whatever data was entered, it is not retained. It's okay, I can get back the parameters or get back the results, but the same screen is not retained.
Okay. See, I mean, this is seems to be a programming issue. I mean, there is no such a logic in this. I mean, it's pretty simple. I mean, you can store it in a variable and also do it, or there are several other methods, as I told you, that activity class has lots of other methods. So you can pass the data between different activities. So there are other, again, lots of methods. What you can do is you can just post your programming code on our Moodle link so that we can have a look and just get you back on this. Thank you. Remote center 1269 IRCEM Institute of Information Technology, Banipur, West Bengal. Yes, sir.
Yes, ma'am. It dot APK file format is only important for security purpose or more?
Basically, that is a format using which you can install your application on Android device. There is no other format using which you can install your application on Android device. I mean, that's the significance of dot APK.
Ma'am, it's provide full secure for hackers. Ma'am, it's keep full secure from hackers. When I will create a ID and password, can it be possible to break from the hackers?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, see, now that depends on philosophy. Android is a complete open source. Source code is available. Everything is available. So if you see some phones are rooted, what do they do is, I mean, they give a super admin access to you and you can do lot of things in it. You can hack it, you can, you know, introduce lot of things. So that depends on philosophy. Yes, it is possible, but whether that depends again whether your device is rooted or not. Thank you. Any other questions, sir?
Yes, ma'am. My question is, we know from very beginning that the Java is very secure. Then how is it possible to convert a Java bytecode which is created by the Java compiler is converted to the Dalvik bytecode by the Dex compiler?
So, I mean, that is, see, what DX compiler does is it optimizes the Java bytecode which has already compiled by the Java compiler. What is, I mean, how it is doing, it's the inside of the DX compiler itself. It just optimizes the Java bytecode at certain layers so that the Dalvik bytecode becomes a very small, so that, you know, it would be executable, it will be executing at very fast speed.
That means, ma'am, the DVM is on based on Java platform.
Basically, there is as such no dependency that it is based on a Java platform. Remote Center 1244, Archana College of Engineering, Palamel, Kerala. Yes, sir.
Madam, I have a doubt that in Windows-based system, the security problem is huge. And while we are considering a Linux-based and Java-based system, the security problem is much lesser. So I would like to know how much the threats and worms are affected in Akash tablet. And by any application like antivirus, is it possible to reduce that? Or up to what extent we can use any such type of applications?
So basically, I mean, you have answered in your question itself, because Linux has a powerful security system, and I don't think so you have anytime heard about that Linux has been, the virus has been introduced in a Linux. So that's what is applicable for Android, because it is based on the Linux kernel. So it is purely, I mean, it's completely secure. There is no as such antivirus issue with a tablet also. 1075 DY Patil College of Engineering and Technology, Kolhapur. Yes, sir, go ahead.
Good evening, ma'am. Hello. Good
yes.
evening, ma'am. My question is, what is scope of compatibility for new Android version with any other device?
Scope of compatibility of, see, that depends. I have already told you that depends on which version your, you know, device is supporting. I mean, let it be now, right now it's 4.2 Jelly Bean. Maybe there will be some new version, but, you know, if your device, it is all dependent on what your device is supporting. So it's a hardware thing, I mean.
Suppose I am developing a new application in for the Android, then whether it is compatible for the new Android version or not?
So that depends on which version your application is compiling in, right? I have already given you example in the morning that suppose I have application compiled in 4.0 ICS, ice cream sandwich, and if I am trying to run it on a device which has a Jelly Bean 4.1, yes, it will work because there is a forward compatibility, right? So it is, yes, it will work. That depends definitely with what API level, what version your application is compiling in and what your device is supporting. These are the two main factors. Thank you, sir. Any other question?
During the launching of AVD, we came across one error. The error said panic could not open the AVD name, whichever name we gave while launching it. So, can you please explain what this error meant?
Okay, so for that you have to just check that your you have a targeted version and your compiled version. Suppose if you are using any version you have not installed properly, because of that, and you are selecting that particular version, because of that you will get this kind of launching error.
So basically, if you have not installed a corresponding API or corresponding version, and you are targeting your AVD to that version, then it won't work. We haven't come across exactly this error, but this issue seems to be similar to the what we have explained. Thank you, and we will stop the session now.